Custom Mode helps you take Launchpad further, and in this session, I'll be showing you how to use the accompanying Components software to build Custom Mode templates for performing and producing glitchy beats and serious bass. Although I'm using Launchpad Pro for this, Custom Mode templates are available on Launchpads of all sizes. Plus, all of the templates and the live project are available for download. Making Custom Mode templates is done using a free Novation application called Components, your gateway to going deeper with Novation products that can be accessed through your internet browser or as a standalone app on your computer. Once the hardware is connected, you can start creating one right away, simply by dragging and dropping any of the available widgets onto the Launchpad display, where they can be moved around and customized using the options alongside. Whenever you want to try out your setup, you can click to instantly send it to one of the Launchpad hardware's 8 slots, after which you can access it by pressing the Custom Mode button and then the corresponding slot with the 8 buttons below the pads. So let's look at an example of building a template, starting with this beat glitcher. I've got a drum rack here then, loaded with 4 samples on the first 4 pads. And I should say I'm using the new drum sampler for these one-shots as opposed to simpler, because it features some great effects. In particular, I'm interested in stretch for these drums, as it's a really nice grain delay. As you can see, I've mapped the delay amount and size, or factor and grain, to the first 2 macros in the drum rack. So if we wanted to now play our rack and adjust these macros using Launchpad, then we can first use the drum grid widget in Components, which I'll have on the right side so I can play with my right hand and maybe change the color. And then I can add vertical unipolar faders alongside for the macros. And a handy shortcut here is to hold down Alt and then drag out the fader, so I have a duplicate. Then just change the CC number to something else, like go up by 1. Then I'll send that to Launchpad, and I can start playing my rack with the pads now. And now to assign the faders to the macros, I just turn on MIDI map mode and then learn them in the normal way, by clicking the macro and then hitting the fader. One thing I also want to do now though is change up the range, which I can do in the browser. There I'm going to make it so that the grain size only goes up to about 20 milliseconds, so it's nice and glitchy. Another cool thing here is that you can make use of the Launchpad's fader motion, which slows down when you hit pads more gently. So I can create pitch slides as well as jumps. The last part of the template is making use of these additional effects at the end of the chain, which are all designed to create extra color and glitch. Raw, for instance, has some fractal distortion and comb filtering to make things fuzzy and tonal. What I'll do for this one then is show you one way of getting stepped control using multiple buttons with a CC button widget, which I'll copy out so we have 4. And here I'm going to adjust the on value so it goes up incrementally from left to right. This will mean that as I press and hold each button, it'll jump to an increasingly high value as I go from left to right. And I'll add 1 more button at the start, but this one is going to turn the effect on and off. So instead of keeping it on momentary, which only sends a value while the button is held down, I'll change it to toggle, so that I can turn the effect on and off with consecutive presses. And I'll make this button grey so it's dark when the effect is off, and green, or a different lighter colour set down here, when the effect is on. Then to check that out in live, I just send it to Launchpad, then map the first button to the device's on switch, and any of the buttons alongside to the comb filter frequency. So now I've got spectral resonator and grain delay mapped on Launchpad as well, I can start jamming properly with my beats. Now let's check out another example, this time working with bass to create this performance template. First up then on the device chain, I've got Drift, which is an instrument in all versions of Live, so available to everyone. And I've created a bass patch with it, and then racked it up with a load of effects, assigned some macros to key parameters, and then created some snapshots, which is such a cool part of Rax, allowing you to call up instant macro configurations that massively change the sound. So with components now then, I'm going to drag out a keyboard to play it with. And I've actually got a few options here, with a chromatic keyboard, so all MIDI notes, and then a scale one, with just the notes in a particular scale. I'm going with scale, so I'll delete the other one, and then I can choose my scale, like F Dorian, say, and then change the colors if I want to. Next, down at the bottom, I'll add a CC button, which I'll set to trigger, and I'll choose a random CC number higher up for it, and then I'll duplicate these all the way along, with ascending CC numbers for each one, as I want to have them triggering different things. You've probably guessed it, these are going to be mapped to the snapshots in Live. So I'll send the template to Launchpad and then assign them in Live. And then I can play bass lines in my chosen key whilst changing up the sound of the bass with the snapshot buttons. Some extra things I've got going on here are shifter, for making fine pitch slides up and down of up to a semitone, a high pass filter for rolling off the bass, and then a reverb for breakdowns. And I'm controlling these now with Launchpad using a CC button to toggle the filter on and off, a horizontal unipolar fader controlling the reverb dry-wet balance, and then a horizontal bipolar fader on the shifter fine adjust. So this is perfect for pitch slides, like with a pitch wheel on a keyboard. And you've got lots of control with this fader once again, as you can hit it with different strengths to create automatic sweeps of different speeds. Just for extra performance simplicity, I've got two more buttons here as well. A momentary CC button below my keyboard for soloing the bass while I hold it down, and then a trigger CC button with the same number as the pitch slider, so also controlling shifter, but this one just sends an on value of 64 when I press it, halfway between 0 and 127, which will reset the pitch back to the middle. This means that with these three buttons here, I can turn off the filter, remove the reverb, and reset the pitch just with a quick tap of one hand. So this all adds up to a really nice bass performance setup. I hope you've enjoyed and been inspired by this movie. Both the templates and the Ableton Live project are available to download, so check the description for details. And feel free to share with our community any templates and creative ways of using components to customize Launchpad for your own musical needs. We'd love to hear what you're getting up to. See you next time.